the imperative, the infinitive, the present tense, the present perfect, the past perfect. All right, let's begin.
Vær glad. Vær glad. Vær glad.
All right, and so the very first thing here, you see this, vær glad. This is the imperative, and if I want to tell you to be happy, then I would say, vær glad. Imperative is the shortest form. It's the shortest form of the verb. It's a direct command. And the one over here.
At være, eller ikke at være.
Yeah.
At være, eller ikke at være.
Now this one is the infinitive. And what is that? What is this infinitive? The infinitive is the one you see in the dictionary. At være, eller ikke at være. Uh-huh. And very often you'll see an at, at before the infinitive.
At være eller ikke at være. Jeg din far. Jeg din far.
Yes, and so jeg din far is of course I am your father. And this is very basic. Is am or are is. So jeg this is the present tense. And this is the thing that I'm doing right now or doing in general. Then we use the present tense.
Ja, din far. Han var fantastisk. Han var fantastisk.
So, this is the past tense. Eh? Han var fantastisk. He was fantastic or amazing. This is, of course, the most basic verb of all. Eh? At være, to be. So you gotta know all of these. And they're sort of, well, they are actually irregular. And it's annoying, but you still gotta learn it. Han var fantastisk. He was fantastic. In the past.
Han var fantastisk. Du har været venlig i dag. Du har været venlig i dag.
Okay, so this is a little more tricky, at least for some learners. So, du har været venlig i dag is you have been friendly today. Like, meaning that in the day that is still today, it has passed, you have been friendly throughout the whole day. Like, the whole day, the whole time, you have been friendly. That's what it means. So the present perfect is what we use when it's something that is connected to the present but happened in the past. Well, often it started in the past, eh? And then it's still going on in the present. There's also other cases where we use it, but you'll see that soon enough.
Du har været venlig i dag. Jeg havde været doven i lang tid. Jeg havde været doven i lang tid.
Okay, so this one is what we call før datid, past perfect. I had been lazy for a long time, or in Danish, jeg havde været doven i lang tid. Now, this is a little bit different, because this is when you're already in the past. Like, let's say you're describing a situation, and then before that, something had already been going on, or something had already happened, right? Which is why we call it før datid, like the pre-past, and it sounds silly in English, of course. The thing that happened or started happening before the past that you're already talking about. And it's very important that you know the difference between har været and havde været. You have been or I had been.
Jeg havde været doven i lang tid. Gør det. Gør det.
Okay, so, gør det. Do it. This is the imperative, and as you can see, there is no E, because the E, that would be the infinitive, right? Gør det. Do it.
Gør det. Kan du gøre noget? Kan du gøre noget?
Right, so, like I just said, this is the infinitive. Kan du gøre noget? And it needs to be infinitive, because you have can right here. If you have another verb first, like whatever the verb basically, then the second verb needs to be infinitive. Can du gøre, can you do? It's kind of like in English, best illustrated in the third person. Like, he drinks. I think that's present tense, he drinks. But you could not say, he can drinks. So, yeah, just think about that. It's very important that when you have the first verb, and you can call it the dominant verb, then the second one is infinitive. Very nice.
Kan du gøre noget? Han gør det for mig. Han gør det for mig.
Okay, that's nice. So han gør det for mig. Now, this is a little bit funny because it's actually the same as the imperative, eh? But we do have some of those where they overlap or they share the same spelling. So han gør det for mig. He does it for me or he's doing it for me. Don't worry about like present continuous or something. That's an English problem, not in Danish. Han gør det for mig. Eh? He does it for me.
Han gør det for mig. Jeg gjorde det i går. Jeg gjorde det i går.
Okay, very nice, beautiful. So, jeg gjorde det i går. And gjorde is of course the past tense. I did it. And yes, this is irregular. We have a J in there, and we have a D that's silent in gjorde, but that is how we say it. Jeg gjorde det i går. I did it yesterday.
Jeg gjorde det i går. Hun har allerede gjort nok. Hun har allerede gjort nok.
Okay, so hun har allerede gjort nok. She has already done enough. This could be different situations. Like maybe it's like she's already helped enough. Or maybe it's kind of sarcastic, like, oh, she messed up everything. She just needs to be passive now. But whatever the case, it is something that she's already done it. And it wasn't like a long time ago. It's relating to the present. It's relating to the now. So yeah, it's very important that you get that. We don't use this about the past like you would in English. And we use present perfect a lot more in Danish than in English. Because in English you would say, oh, I watched a good movie, and like you just watched it 5 minutes ago. But in Danish, we'll get to this later, then you would say, jeg har set, jeg har lige set, I have just watched or just seen. So yeah, we use it a lot more than you do in English.
Hun har allerede gjort nok. Lægen havde gjort noget forkert. Lægen havde gjort noget forkert.
Okay, yes. So lægen havde gjort noget forkert. The doctor had done something wrong. Of course, what this is that it's in the past, but it's before the past. So let's say the doctor is, this happened 5 years ago, that you're talking to the doctor, and then prior to that, already before that, he had done something wrong. Før datid, past perfect.
Lægen havde gjort noget forkert. Ha' en god dag. Have en god dag.
Okay, so ha' en god dag. This is very nice. And if you live in Denmark, I'm sure you heard it a lot of times. Right? Ha' en god dag. Have a good day or have a nice day. And again, this is the imperative. It's someone telling you to have a good day. It is technically, grammatically a command. Even though it might sound weird that it's a command, it is a command. Ha' en god dag.
Ha' en god dag. Jeg vil ikke have mus her. Jeg vil ikke have mus her.
Okay, very good. So, jeg vil ikke have mus her, og ikke have. But in real life, we rarely say have. That's just like dictionary pronunciation. Jeg vil ikke have mus her. And again, it's the infinitive. Because vil, that's another verb, and that is in the present tense. Eh? Jeg vil ikke, I don't. Hey, I don't want. Jeg vil ikke have mus her. Yeah, very nice. And it's also what you would use if it's like to have. Eh? Oh, it's good to have that. Eh? Det gotta have. It's good to have. That's how we say it. And I know a lot of you must be quite annoyed with the fact that we just pronounce it like H-A, hey. And this is why when we write song lyrics, then we just write H-A apostrophe. But that's not correct.
Jeg vil ikke have mus her. Hvad har du der? Hvad har du der?
Okay, hvad har du der? Is the present tense, eh? Because what do you have there? What have you there? It's right now, eh? It's not before, it's not in the future, it's right now. Hvad har du der?
Hvad har du der? Damen havde ikke så meget tid. Damen havde ikke så meget tid.
Okay, så damen havde ikke så meget tid. The woman, or the lady is maybe more appropriate, didn't have so much time. Havde is the past. And this one can be a little bit frustrating, because the pronunciation in havde, you don't say the V. Yeah, let's take that again. Havde, right? Damen havde. The V is not pronounced. You don't say havde, or havde, or havde. I can't even say that. We don't say that, okay? havde. Basically, like without the V, but if you spell it without a V, then you're saying hate, and like to hate. So don't do that. Or at least be careful.
Damen havde ikke så meget tid. Du har haft meget travlt. Du har haft meget travlt.
Okay, so du har haft meget travlt. You have been very busy. Like this could be you see your friend, and then recently, leading up to this point, leading up to the present, he or she has been busy. Right? Du har haft meget travlt. And also look at the spelling here. Har haft.
Du har haft meget travlt. De havde haft den i lang tid. De havde haft den i lang tid.
Yes, so this looks very similar. But again, de havde. Right? In English, that's they had had. Doesn't sound so good. But in Danish, de havde haft den. Because it's in the past, but it's prior to the past. It started before the given past.
De havde haft den i lang tid. Lav den til mig. Lav den til mig.
It can sound a bit strange, but it's good grammar. Lav den til mig. This is, of course, the imperative. Like, you are telling someone directly to make something for you. So there is no E. Lav den til mig. And the V here, the V is almost pronounced like a U. Right? We don't say lav or lav. We say lav. Lav den til mig. Lav den til mig. Different accents, different dialects. Lav den til mig.
Lav den til mig. Skal vi lave en film? Skal vi lave en film?
Alright, this is very typical me. Always something about movies, right? Skal vi lave en film? Shall we make a film? Or do you want to make a movie? Or how you want to translate it? Again, lave is infinitive, eh? Because you have skal right here. Skal is the present tense. Skal vi lave en film?
Skal vi lave en film? Han laver ikke noget. Han laver ikke noget.
Okay, that's super. Han laver ikke noget. It's of course the present tense because it ends with an R. So han laver ikke noget. And that's so convenient about the Danish language that the verbs, they almost always end with an R in the present tense. Right? So you can tell what tense it is.
Han laver ikke noget. Jeg lavede den i sidste uge. Jeg lavede den i sidste uge.
Okay, yeah, there it is. Jeg lavede den I sidste uge. I made it last week. Lavede. And here it gets interesting, like grammar-wise. If you look at the ending, lavede. This is the past tense. All you gotta do here is to put de to lave. Right? We have lave or lave right up here, and then you add the de. Then you get the past tense. Now, you cannot do this to all verbs, as you probably already know. But there are many verbs where you can do this. Maybe, I mean, just a rough estimate, like 30 or 40%. Eh? Like a whole lot of verbs, you can do this. So, lavede. Eh? And that's a soft D. When you see a verb ending like this, the D is soft, not hard. Don't say lavede. Eh? That is funny, but it's not correct.
Jeg lavede den I sidste uge. Hvad har du lavet I dag? Hvad har du lavet I dag?
Yeah, so, hvad har du lavet I dag? Eh? What have you done today? Or maybe, what have you been doing today? Eh? So, like, it could be the end of the day or some point during the day and we're thinking, well, so far, what have you been doing? Eh? Hvad har du lavet I dag? Then, of course, there's the whole, like, what's the difference between lave and gøre? I'm not really gonna get into that today. Maybe another time.
Hvad har du lavet I dag? Jeg havde ikke lavet den før. Jeg havde ikke lavet den før.
This før, before, is already in the past. And then we go even further back. Right? Before that, before the past. It can be a little bit tricky to wrap your head around at first. But it's pretty logical.
Jeg havde ikke lavet den før. Få den her. Få den her.
Yeah, that's nice. Få den her can actually have two meanings. Like, get this one or get it here. Like, so, again, this is someone telling another person to do something. Like, get it. There is no R, there is no E. Like, få. This is the shortest possible form of this verb. Få den her.
Få den her. Jeg kan ikke få nok. Jeg kan ikke få nok.
Yes, so this one can be a little bit confusing because få here, like this is the infinitive, but it looks the same. It looks the same as the imperative, and the same spelling. So you have to tell from the context. Jeg kan ikke få nok. Of course, can is the present tense. Jeg kan ikke. So if you accidentally said for, like you added an R, that would be wrong. But okay, I've said that many times already. Let's just move on.
Jeg kan ikke få nok. Hvad får du om måneden? Hvad får du om måneden?
Yes, so here it is. Ink. What do you get per month? This is monetary amounts. And we use the present tense here because it refers to the present or something that's going on in general. Ink. Like every month or every week or just anything that's general. When it's general, recurring, frequent, then we say this. Ink. For.
Hvad får du om måneden? Han fik vist en masse penge. Han fik vist en masse penge.
Yes, so han fik vist en masse penge is of course, it seemed like he got a lot of money. Right? And fik is the past tense. It's the past tense and it's irregular. We don't like that, do we? Yeah, so it's important you say fik and not fåde or fået. Well, fået is down here as another one. But the past tense is fik. Right? And fik vist en masse penge. And a little side note. Vist is like it seems or it seemed. And kind of like it seemed that way. Huh, okay. Kind of like that.
Han fik vist en masse penge. Hun havde fået noget chokolade. Hun havde fået noget chokolade.
Havde fået noget chokolade og har fået noget chokolade. It's actually just different tenses. Is gotten some chocolate. And if we look at this one. Du har fået noget chokolade is you have gotten, like you have it right now because you have received it before.
Du havde fået chefens nummer. Du havde fået chefens nummer.
Okay, so du havde fået chefens nummer is of course you had got or gotten the boss's number. Right? It was in the past and it was before that.
Du havde fået chefens nummer. Spis lidt hurtigere. Spis lidt hurtigere.
Yeah, gotta love this. In real life, you don't have to say hurtigere unless you want to make a point. So, spis lidt hurtigere. This is the shortest form, so you don't say the E. That's all it is. Just be aware that if you walk around and always use this imperative, it can sound a little bit strong. Like you are very bossy and commanding. So just be aware of that.
Spis lidt hurtigere. Jeg burde spise mere fisk.
Yeah.
Jeg burde spise mere fisk.
Yeah, so once again, you see there's another verb before. Jeg burde spise. Yeah, I ought to eat more fish. Yeah, there's actually more Danish words for ought or should, but this is just one of them.
Jeg burde spise mere fisk. Hun spiser lige nu. Hun spiser lige nu.
It's a very good point, ink. So hun spiser lige nu, or han spiser lige nu, is of course eating right now. If your mind is all like in English or Spanish or some other language, you're like, oh, but is it eats or is eating? Like, no, that's the same in Danish. Of course, we do have ways of saying that the person is doing it right now, like emphasizing it without saying now. But it's not that important in Danish, not like in many other languages. So you have some more flexibility there. So that's pretty cool.
Han spiste for meget ost. Han spiste for meget ost.
Okay, han spiste for meget ost. He ate too much cheese. Lovely. So this is the past tense. Right? But with this verb, it ends with te. Or you can say it another way. To get the past tense, you just have to put the t in spiste. Right? Like between the s and the e, just put a t and then you got it. Right? Han spiste for meget ost.
Han spiste for meget ost. Jeg har allerede spist. Jeg har allerede spist.
Okay, so jeg har allerede spist. This is such a good example of what present perfect is. Because in English you would say, I already ate, like at least a lot of time. But in Danish, if you say, jeg spiste allerede, we would be like, okay, when? Like if you use the past tense in Danish, the context needs to be established first. Okay? Whereas if you just did something, you would say, jeg har spist. And then, of course, you can add allerede to already, emphasizing it. But yeah, it's very important that you use the present perfect and not the past tense.
Jeg har allerede spist. Du havde lige spist en banan. Du havde lige spist en banan.
Alright, du havde lige spist en banan. Ikke? You had just eaten a banana. This is, of course, because, I already said it so many times, the thing that happened before the past. Like maybe he was getting ready to do something, but right before that, he had eaten a banana. Like that.
Du havde lige spist en banan. Drik noget vand. Drik noget vand.
Drik noget vand, ikke? Drink some water. And it's short. And notice that there's only one K. So here it's drik, and then over here is drik with two K's. In Danish, you cannot end with a double consonant.
Kan du drikke vodka? Kan du drikke vodka?
Okay, very good question. Very useful for conversation. Kan du drikke vodka? And here you see there are two K's. Kan du drikke in this lovely infinitive.
Kan du drikke vodka?
Altid.
Jeg drikker for meget juice. Jeg drikker for meget juice.
Okay, interesting. Yeah, so of course this is the, what is this? The present tense. Jeg drikker. Jeg drikker for lidt. Kind of like that. So this is what you would say when it's like in general. It's not right now. It's not in this moment. But it is habitual. Or it is a regular thing.
Jeg drikker for meget juice. De gamle drak en masse mælk.
Who says this?
De gamle drak. En masse mælk.
This shit is crazy. So, de gamle drak en masse mælk. Ikke? The old ones, or old people, drank a lot of milk. And this is the past tense. So, as you can see, it's irregular. And that can be really annoying. But it is what it is. De gamle drak en masse mælk. Please don't say drikkede. I know it's tempting, but don't do it.
De gamle drak en masse mælk. Vi har drukket lidt te. Vi har drukket lidt te.
Yes, yes, that's just awesome, ikke? Vi har drukket lidt te. It's something that happened maybe a while ago or earlier in the day, ikke? It's not like isolated in the past, and therefore you use the present perfect.
Vi har drukket lidt te. Havde du drukket meget sodavand? Havde du drukket meget sodavand?
Okay, ikke? So past perfect here. Havde du drukket, had you drunk, ikke? A lot of soda.
Havde du drukket meget sodavand? Gå derover.
Okay, so you see this, right? This is of course imperative, gå derover. But once again, it's the same in infinitive. And we just have some of those. It's a little bit annoying. It is what it is. Gå derover, and jeg vil gå en tur. Right? But this is clearly a command, because it's so short. So it has to be a command.
Gå derover. Jeg vil gå en tur. Jeg vil gå en tur.
Okay, so jeg vil gå en tur. Again, we have vil as the present tense and go infinitive. Jeg vil gå en tur.
Jeg vil gå en tur. Du går for hurtigt. Du går for hurtigt.
Okay, du går for hurtigt. You walk too fast. All we did here is put an R. Right? You have go here. And then to make a present tense, you just add an R, eh? Du går for hurtigt. And a little side note, although it's not the main point now. Hurtigt, eh? I add the T because it's an adverb, eh? Like too fast, too quickly. Eh? Because it's the way it's being done. It's the way it's happening. So if I said du går for hurtigt, no, that's wrong. Du går for hurtigt. T at the end.
Du går for hurtigt. De gik på græsset.
Okay.
De gik på græsset.
Okay, so de gik på græsset, eh? They walked on the grass. This is again irregular. And you can rewatch this video, of course, as many times as you want. It does take time to learn the right way to conjugate. In the beginning, it's gonna suck, I'm not gonna lie. But once you remember the irregular ones, it gets a lot easier.
De kigger på græsset. Hvem har gået en tur? Hvem har gået en tur?
Hvem har gået en tur? Who went for a walk, or who has gone out for a walk, I suppose. So, all of these are weird out of context, but hvem har gået en tur, ikke? Like, the person is out now. We know someone is on a walk. Who is that? Right? Still going on.
Hvem har gået en tur? Han havde gået i et par timer. Han havde gået i et par timer.
Oh yeah, this is a good one. So, you know, this could be that, if we continue it, han havde gået et par timer, og så så han en bjørn. Like, he had been walking for a few hours, and then he saw a bear. Right? So, like, the main thing is that he saw the bear. But before that, he had already been walking for a few hours. So that's why we use that. Havde gået, had been walking. Oh yeah.
Han havde gået i et par timer. Løb hvis du kan. Løb hvis du kan. Løb.
So, løb hvis du kan, right, is of course run if you can. And again, this is the imperative, right? Løb hvis du kan.
Du må ikke løbe her. Du må ikke løbe her.
All right, no running allowed, right? Du må ikke løbe her. So, må is kind of like must or may, or it's not allowed, right? Like it's not okay. Du må ikke løbe her. And it's important, of course, that you don't add an R, but you already know that. Even some Danish people, although I suspect it's mostly laziness, when they write, they're gonna put the R in the infinitive, and I'm like, what the hell? What's that? Right? But don't repeat that. If there is one verb, like here in the beginning, then the second verb cannot have an R. I'm happy to repeat that, because it's very important.
Du må ikke løbe her. Jeg løber hver morgen. Jeg løber hver morgen.
Jeg løber hver morgen, ikke? Of course means that it's the present tense, ikke? It's something that goes on a regular basis or right now. Jeg løber. Yeah. But if you change the pronunciation a little bit and say løber, then it's a runner, ikke? The noun, someone who runs. So that can be a little bit interesting. Like there are sometimes where it's both a verb and a noun, but then luckily from time to time the pronunciation changes, or the stress changes, the glottal stop. So you have a chance. It's not completely random and unpredictable.
Hun løb, fordi hun var bange. Hun løb, fordi hun var bange.
Oh no. So, hun løb, fordi hun var bange. And this one, ooh, this can be frustrating to look at. Eh? Løb, but I thought løbe was the imperative. It is. It's both. What are you going to do? Eh? Hun løb, fordi hun var bange. So this is also what we say in the past tense. You might be tempted to say løbede og løbte, but that would not be right. That would just be wrong.